What is up, everybody? It is Blaze back again, bringing you some more information related to our favorite game, Marvel's Avengers. Today is the weekly reset, and we have an updated war table. Happy Thursday, Marvel fans, and welcome to our Marvel Avenger War Table weekly blog, where we will give you the scoop on news, patch notes, marketplace updates, and more. Pertaining to the priority missions, delve into the depths of two shield vaults in this week's priority missions. Priority missions have modifiers that will challenge even the toughest superhero. Your first weekly completion of these missions earn you unique gear that you won't find anywhere else. Desert Vault looks like it's going to be a low power level, as it says right next to it, with the modifiers Famine, Outbreak, and Collider. Guaranteed rewards are Polychoron and hero specific gear. For the Tundra Vault, which is a high power level, modifiers are going to be Turmoil, Resurgence, Clash, and Snowball, with the guaranteed reward of epic gear. Next, we have the priority harm challenges. Priority harm room challenges have additional modifiers and reward comics that increase your collection and boost your stats. Those passive stats are lovely. Make sure you're paying attention to those. Your first weekly completion reward is going to be the 2010's Black Widow number 5, which gives you 0.5% status resistance. The low power level challenge is going to have the modifiers of Oasis and Torpedo, and the high power level challenge will have the modifiers of Famine, Clash, and Cosmos. Modifier pro tips. This is something that I did kind of want to cover as well, because everybody needs to know what the modifiers are. Modifiers are game changers. Famine. Focusing on takedowns and careful usage of the regenerative nanite containers are key to survivability when famine is active. Collider. Equipped any gear that provides additional particle damage or increase the rate at which the particle status meter build to really heat things up when Collider is active. Resurgence. Quickly eliminating a single foe as opposed to bouncing around between multiple enemies or trying to control groups within AoE area of effect damage will help make surviving resurgence easier. When Clash is active, make sure to play a hero who has strong melee abilities and equip gear high in the melee attribute. Don't forget, enemies also inflict greater melee damage, so watch out for combatants who try to get in close. Ooh, that makes me think of the stiletto motherfuckers. Those those off-brand fake Wolverine ass people. Oh my god, those robots are so annoying. They're so annoying. Torpedo. It is best to select heroes with strong range attacks or equip gear high in the precision attribute to best take advantage of Torpedo. Don't forget, enemy range attacks also do more damage, so be sure to dodge and evade incoming projectiles. That is easier said than done, because until they fix the indicator pertaining to ranged attacks that the enemies sometimes use, you're going to end up getting hit. And it's really, really, really annoying, because it doesn't make any sense how some ranged attacks from some enemies are not shown before they hit you. So you'll be fighting, watching, paying attention to the indicators, like if an enemy is about to attack you or anything like that, and then all of a sudden you just get shot out of nowhere. Done. Dead. Down. On the ground. Feels bad. It looks like we have a monthly PlayStation exclusive community challenge. Awesome. Good for everybody who's on PlayStation. Go ahead and team up with PlayStation fans worldwide to meet mega goals and unlock rewards. Sometimes enemies just need to be defeated with bare fists. Doesn't hurt that it feels that much more heroic. Defeat 750 million enemies with melee attacks. That's a lot. But it looks like if you're able to do that, you get a crisp, uncommon nameplate for Miss Marvel. And I like her. Miss Marvel is good. I think she's a really good character, and she might be a little bit underrated. She could be better, but I don't think she's necessarily in a bad spot. Lastly, for this week, it looks like they have some more marketplace updates featuring some more skins, emotes, and takedowns, as well as a nameplate. They look pretty nice. I'm gonna have to check them out in game to see what it's really about, to be honest. So on a final note, the update version 1.3.0 unfortunately did not come out today as of Thursday, which is the reset. So hoping that it's going to be coming out tomorrow. However, it does say that it's going to be dropping soon, and the section below will be updated as soon as it's live. As soon as it is live, I'm going to try to cover it as well, going through the update, everything that's been changed, and basically just see what we can expect going forward as this update hopefully makes the game better fixes a lot of bugs, and overall just makes it more optimized and stable. Because one thing that I really hate when playing this game is getting into a mission like the Elite Heroic Hive, doing 14 floors, and then somehow getting connected halfway through or right at the end. Like, that just hurts my soul. It hurts my soul because I'm just like, you know what I mean? You know what I mean. Anyway, that is going to be it for today's. Want to go ahead and let you guys know that I do stream on Twitch. Link will be in the description. Go ahead and click on it. Go to my page and hit that follow button if you want to catch me live at any time playing Marvel Avengers, Destiny 2, or anything that I'm going to be playing on that day. I'm not really too sure, to be honest. But thank you for watching. Hit that like and subscribe down below so you can keep up to date with any information that I'm also posting to YouTube. It would mean a lot to me. You guys have a great day, and laters.